Dear friends, always it is pleasure for me, particularly when I with the audience like you, it is really a great satisfaction for me. The infrastructure development in the country is very important. Actually, government has decided to giving highest priority for development of infrastructure in the country. In India, we have 58 lakh kilometers of roads, out of which only at the time when I taken charge as a minister, 96,000 kilometers as a national highway. Presently, this 96,000 kilometers is increased from 96,000 kilometers to 1,37,000 kilometers. So 40% of the traffic at that time was on national highway. And today also, by increasing the length, the 2% road having more than 80% traffic of the country. And that is the one of the reason that national highway we have a lot of accidents. As far as the road accidents are concerned, in the country we have 5 lakhs accidents, 1,50,000 deaths, and this is the highest in the world. So for the road accident, not only the highways are responsible, but highway engineering, automobile engineering, in road traffic rules, regulations, all the things which now the country, it is important for the country to, we have to reform this sector. The road sector, when I taken charge as minister, we have 3,85,000 crores of 406 project was the toll project. In Indian scenario, we have a problem that we need forest environment clearances, utility shifting, land acquisition. And for all this thing, delay is there. And because of delay, the financial account coming up to the end of NPA. And then banks stop the finance. And then again, there are a lot of complications are there. But particularly in my regime, we resolved the issue. 95% of the issue we resolved. And now the road sector is moving fast. Last year, up to the March, our road construction was 30 kilometers per day. Actually, it starts from 2 kilometers per day, comes to 30 kilometers per day. But now we are planning for making of new green express highway. And the Bharatmala is one of the ambitious program for the government of India, where 65,000 kilometer road length we have already taken in Bharatmala, and 10,000 NHDP program balance length also is added in it. So it is 75,000 kilometer of road length in Bharatmala. Out of which first phase, we have taken 24,000 kilometer. Already we have started 9,000 kilometer works, and there are new 22 green express highway. Now you just take the example of Delhi-Mumbai. Now we have new alignment starting from Gurgaon. From Gurgaon to Savai Madhopur Alwar, going to Jhabua, Ratlam, and then going to Vadodara to Mumbai. By this new alignment, we are saving the distance between Delhi to Mumbai by 240 kilometers. Now the most interesting case is the alignment of this new Delhi-Mumbai Express Highway. It is 12-lane cement concrete road, access control. So the most important thing is this highway started from the backward and tribal area of Haryana, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, and Maharashtra. So the project cost is 1 lakh crore. And in this alignment, we have already saved 16,000 crore on land acquisition. Because the present alignment, Delhi, Ahmedabad, Vadodara, Mumbai, is the busiest corridor, developed area, and that the reason that the land acquisition cost was very high. But because of this new innovative planning, by which we are selecting the backward and tribal area, and also because of road that area is going to develop, so we saved the 16,000 crore on land acquisition. We have completed the land acquisition. We have already started the project. Vadodara, Mumbai is in the process. Immediately we will start that part of the road. And within 3 years, our planning is to complete this road. Already the work is started, and it will take from Delhi to Mumbai only 12 hours. You can easily go by 110-120 kilometers per hour. So this type of 22 new express highway we are making, because the most problematic situation in the country for the industry is our logistic cost is very high. So now from the existing length, Delhi, Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Vadodara, every month the truck can take maximum 5 to 6 trips. But because of this next new express highway, they can take 10 to 12 trips. And at the same time, we are making a first e-highway. That is 10 kilometers of highway we are taking as a pilot project of electric highway. The truck and bus will run on that highway for some time, taking the power from the cable. And again, main road, they will come and they will go with the speed. So this is the idea. So electric as a fuel is very cheap. So I feel that by making this type of highway, we can reduce the logistic cost. In China, the logistic cost is 8 to 10%. In European countries, logistic cost is 10 to 12%. And in India, the logistic cost is 16 to 18%. And that is one of the reasons that we are not very much competitive in the international market. So you go anywhere in the Europe, either Italy or UK, anywhere, the industrial area is nearer to the river. And actually in our country, it is prohibited. So they take their material, the container from river and take it to the port. So for example, going by waterways, cost is very less. For example, going by road is 10 rupees. Going by railway is 6 rupees. Going by waterways is only 1 rupees. So we have taken decision to giving priority for waterways. Previously, last regime, when I was minister for waterways, we have started work of 10 waterways. Out of which Ganga, that is from Varanasi to Haldia, 1,380 kilometers is completed. There is 4 multimodal hub at Varanasi, Sahibganj, both are inaugurated by Prime Minister. And Haldia and Ghazipur work is going on. After Haldia, by Bengal Sea, we can go to Brahmaputra. We have completed the dredging in Brahmaputra. Then we completed dredging in Barak. And even at that time, we taken initiative to complete the dredging for Chitgao and Mungli port. And now Allahabad, Prayagraj to Varanasi also, the draft is maintained. It is, the work is already completed, the 1 meter draft. So you cannot take the big vessel. And now the DPR, which is prepared and submitted to World Bank, that from Delhi, Yamuna, by Delhi going to Mathura, Mathura to Agra, Agra to Itawan, Itawa to Prayagraj, Allahabad. So the 12,000 crore project is ready. If we can complete this project, we can take any material from Delhi through Yamuna up to Myanmar, Bangladesh, Northeast, West Bengal, anywhere, Jharkhand, Bihar, by waterways. So the another advantage most important is 7,500 kilometers of seafront. So the vehicle which we are manufacturing in Chennai, they are coming to Delhi by road transport. And the car of Maruti and other, they are manufacturing here, they are taking by truck and going to Chennai. So we have tried to start a RoRo service. And now the sector, we need more investment. I will request you, all of you, this is the future. So you can think about it to invest in it. We have started one cruise service from Mumbai to Goa. His name is Angria. He's gotten good response for that. So even we plan in Mumbai, through BPT, our DPR is ready. That new port is going on, construction is going on in New Mumbai. The idea is from anywhere from Mumbai, within 20 minutes, you can go to airport from the sea route. So project is ready. So there is a huge potential in the manufacturing of catamaran, hovercrafts, seaplane. And these are the transport new innovative fields where you can invest and the economic viability is there. The technology is available. So the waterways and the roads, the first priority is to waterways, second to railway, and third to road. But I am minister for road construction. Fortunately, road traffic is increased. I never understand it is good or bad. As a country, it is a bad thing. As a department, it is a good thing. So now, it is the time for us to find out the new options. Just one of the interesting projects I am doing in Nagpur, that is broad gauge metro. We have a metro in Nagpur now, the work as long as it's completed now. And 65% of the metro is on solar power. So now we have decided to connect Nagpur by broad gauge metro. So the idea is from Wardha, Nagpur, Gondia. Gondia, Nagpur, Narkhed. Gondia, Nagpur, going up to Savner. And Ramtek to, these are all stations, is a satellite cities near to Nagpur. We want to connect it on broad gauge. So Nagpur Metro, we have taken initiative. Now we have a joint venture with an Italian company. And we are starting manufacturing of rolling stock of broad gauge metro and standard gauge metro in Nagpur near Wardha district, where our dry port is there in Sindhi. And we are trying to making of all, using of all aluminum for making of this rolling stocks. So my suggestion is the cost of capital cost for broad gauge metro is only 3 to 4 crore rupees per kilometer. And capital cost for construction of metro is 3 crore per kilometer. So just you take the example of Delhi connecting Jaipur, then connecting to Chandigarh, connecting to Kanpur, or some nearer to area to Mathura. If we can use the same broad gauge signal system, no expenditure is there, and the particularly four rolling stock, air-conditioned broad gauge metro, if you can take it for that, it can be a very, very cost-effective solution for our public transport. Now in ministry also, today we have a meeting. We are now formulating the national transport policy. One point to other point, from Jaipur to Delhi, Delhi to Ludhiana, Delhi to Kanpur. The idea is just like private airlines are available now in place of that double-decker electric or biofuel buses. The ground part will be of executive class, higher will be economic class. Just like in airport, we can make the smart, particularly the transport port for using of all these things. Now already we have started to making bus port now, like airport. Economically viable, IRR is good. So 2,800 commercial good places are available, where we can construct the bus port with the public-private investment. And we can start a double-decker buses or luxury buses with comfort level. No one will use his car. From coming from Chandigarh to Delhi with a luxury bus in an executive class, if the comforts are there, why people will use the car? So now this is the time for the country to encourage more public transport, particularly on electricity. And when I was minister at that time in Water Resources Ministry, we have signed the agreement with the world-famed company named as Doffelmayr. Their share in the world market is 65% in cable car, ropeway, funicular railway, monorail, light rail transport. They have a sky double-decker bus having capacity of 260 people. The capital cost per kilometer is less than metro. It is only coming to 50 crore rupees. And capacity is the same like metro. So at that time, we planned to make it from Dhaulakuwa to Manesar. This is the very busiest corridor. And this Dhaulakuwa was a big problem. But my ministry has taken a decision to make the roads of 50,000 crores in Delhi. We are making the Dwarka Express Highway, Ghaziabad, Faridabad, everywhere we are now making the roads. We have this Delhi Meerut Express Highway, 14-lane road we have already completed. Now Delhi to Meerut, it takes 4.5 hours. But next 4 to 5 months, after completing this road, it will be only 40 minutes from Meerut to Delhi. So now the idea is that we need to have new alternative and new option of transport to the people. And we can use electricity. Even BS6, we have taken a decision. A lot of people, particularly related to the automobile, were very annoyed with me. But the pollution is a big concern. So now, successfully, our manufacturer are already now launching their cars with the BS6 standards. So even in Delhi, because of the ring road, easterly and westerly bypass, 30% pollution is already reduced. And now one of the plant making bio-CNG from Parali, rice straw, is now successfully completed. Even in my own constituency, we have also the project making methane from fruit, vegetable waste and mutton, machi market waste and sludge. Our city, my constituency and Nagpur Municipal Corporation, the one of the city that we are selling our sewage water, toilet water, to government of Maharashtra, getting 180 crore rupees royalty per year. So that is the philosophy, that conversion of waste into wealth. Even in Mathura, when I was minister, we awarded the contract to Triveni Engineering, and they are giving 80 MLD of sludge. From Mathura, they are converting into clean water, and they are giving water to Indian Oil, getting 20 crore rupees royalty per year. So I am always advocating that no one is waste. It is depending upon the technology, the leadership, the innovation, the research, that you can convert waste into wealth. It is a very, very favorite subject to me. So waste to wealth, it is really a very interesting theory. So my suggestion is, now there are huge potential is available in the transport sector, particularly in PPP mode. We have got a lot of successful projects. Actually, I remember the days of 95-96. When I was minister in Maharashtra, Mumbai, I got appointed to construct Mumbai-Pune Express Highway, the Varali-Bandra Sea Link project and 55 flyovers in Mumbai. At that time, I raised the money from the capital market, and with the considering interest cost, now we return that money back, and the project are now successfully giving lot of benefit to the people by and large. So last in my regime, in my ministry only, we awarded the contract more than 17 lakh crores. It is not because of budget, but it is because of the public-private investment. So we have now hybrid annuity project, TOT project, BOT project, And now there are a lot of new innovative models by which we can take the cooperation of public-private sector and we can make the infrastructure of international standard. Regarding MSME also, I am minister for that. So I will request you that 29% of the growth of the country is from MSME. And 40% export is also from MSME. And up till now, the 11 crore jobs created by MSME. Now our target is to 50% growth of the country from MSME, then creating 5 crore new jobs and 50% of export. And particularly, I am more concentrating on rural, agriculture, and tribal sector. Diversification of agriculture towards energy and power sector. In the tribal area, we can make bio-aviation fuel. Successfully, last 26 January, our Air Force helicopter and a jet engine, a fighter jet, running on 100% bio-aviation fuel from Jatropha. So we also taken initiative to take a spice jet plane from Dehradun to Delhi by using bio-aviation fuel. Presently, our import is of 40,000 crores. So the rate of bio-aviation fuel is 42 rupees per liter and the present rate is 60 to 70 rupees per kilometer for imported petroleum aviation fuel. So Ratanjot, Moha, Sal, Karanj and Toli, these are the non-edible oil seed. By using the biotechnology, we can increase the production of non-edible oil seed and using it that oil for making of bio-aviation fuel. And we are trying for to making oil from bamboo. We have got bamboo mission now. The Northeast, we have got a lot of bamboo. So these are the new innovations where we can create wealth, we can stop our imports, we can create more employment potential, and at the same time, we can give more jobs. We are also working on honey. Now, I requested Mother Dairy because in my area, Mother Dairy is there. Now they are making honey ice cream. Then we are decided in Bardha, there is Goras Park is a biscuit, very nicely. It is from honey, then milk from cows, gai ka hi doodh hai, or very tasty biscuit. So now I suggested to Mother Dairy to make it this pure biscuit from using honey. It has got a good potential for export. So new innovation, new ideas, and research is very important. I always say that innovation, entrepreneurship, science, technology, research, and skill. We name it as a knowledge. And conversion of knowledge into wealth is the future for the country. So today, the new technology, new innovation, new research is very important. And our government has intention to reform all these sectors. We are trying our level best. We are now, as far as the fuels are concerned, we have 100% bioethanol bike. I really like that Venu Srinivasan from TVS, he has manufactured that. Then Bajaj is also making bike, scooter, auto rickshaw. And the ethanol is from farmers, sugarcane juice. In we are facing problem because of surplus sugar. We have got surplus of wheat, surplus of rice, everything. The farmers are not getting their price because of the production is very high. So this is the time for the country that diversification of agriculture towards energy and power sector. It's a passion for me, I'm not a businessman. But we are making bio-CNG from rice straw. And I have decided in my 6 districts, Nagpur, Bhandara, Gondia, Chandrapur, Wardha, and Gadchiroli, free from diesel. Diesel mukta karna hai. So now we are making bio-CNG from rice straw. 6 plant, already work has started. But fortunately, Napier grass was there. And the caloric value of Napier grass is 6,000 when the 60% moisture is there. So I given to the laboratory, now it's a very good thing. From 3 ton of Napier grass giving 1 ton of bio-CNG. 5 ton of rice straw is giving 1 ton of bio-CNG. 7 ton of cotton straw is giving 1 ton of bio-CNG. And we can use bio-CNG for truck, buses, everywhere. So it is import substitute, cost-effective, pollution-free, and indigenous. So in the transport sector, we need to think about the all successful international practices which are available on the basis of that to make our transport up to that mark, giving priority for public transport. We are already creating new road construction. Every state there are a lot of construction is going on. We are creating waterways. Now the aviation, already the way in which people are giving good response in the aviation sector, 22% rise is there. So my suggestion is come for now, not for bus port, what airport, would be river port. Even in Ganga, we are now welcoming all the people to come there. Now a lot of new companies, Indian companies, foreign companies are interested in water ports. So my suggestion is now our transport sector is in a mode, because Prime Minister's dream is to make India of 21st century, and where we need a very, very international parameter and standard, considering on the basis of that we need the all transport of international standard. But one of the important things should be cost effective, import substitute, pollution free and indigenous. So the huge potential is there. And I'm confident that people like you, with your own vision, you can plan new ideas. I always insisting and talking to the people that you can donate eye, but you cannot donate vision. The lack of appropriate vision is very important, and the strong political will, which is more important than capital and technology, that is very important. So you can make the miracles. And it is always a pleasure for me to talking with the people like you who are really interested in development and who want to make something new, innovative for the future. So really it is a pleasure for me. A lot of things are with me, but time constraint is there. So it's again a good experience for me, and I'm giving my all best wishes to you. Thank you very much. Namaskar.